probably see now, I've fixed the elements through the back there. That's how they would have been fixed. Right, okay, here's the back of the cooker, and you can probably see the terminations come straight through there. This is the insulated part there. Right, there you go, that's the first door on. I've got plenty of viewing in there now, so don't forget, when I've got the lights on in there, there's going to be plenty of viewing. I don't need any other panel in the other door, so I'm just going to leave the one in there. That's ideal, I think. And all I've basically done, let's see, it's nice and light still. I'm going to put the insulation in here now, obviously, as you know, and then put the inner metal around it as well. And all I've basically done there, as you can probably see there, is held the glass in down the sides, the top and bottom, or it can't slide down because of the support rail there. So I'm going to put the insulation on, obviously, then I've got to make a return somehow for the actual door. I'm not really too worried about it, but one thing I have noticed as well is that to take these doors on and off, you need to have access to these little clips there. So what I'm going to do is just cut a little L shape out of the backing plate and then just put another little plate over the top and bottom, so that I can actually gain access to take the door out if I need to. Right, just insulating the door now, as you can see. I've got that front glass in now. I made a bit of a boo-boo here, because what I should have done, I thought about it and I thought, well, if I'm insulating this, putting the sheet on, the metal, and because I've only got one layer of glass here, the outside's going to be cool, but if you touch that glass is going to be 200 degrees heat as well, because there's no double layer. So I'm having to go for the grill door. Now what I should have done, I should have put this on the outside and the bigger piece of glass on the inside. If you're coming to do the same thing, just be aware that you should have double glass there, because it's got to get red hot that. And also make the bigger glass on the inside as opposed to the outside. Once I've finished insulating properly, as you can probably see, that will go on there like that. Then this glass here will be on the inside of the door. Right, okay then, here we are. I've finished the main frame of the oven. It's all wired in, only temporary at the moment. I've still got some finishing off to do with regards to enclosing the control panel at the back and also the rear panel. I'm gonna sort of enclose all that so the electrics aren't on the show. But let's just run you through it. Right, well, I've not even turned it on yet. Well, as you can see, I've got two skins of glass there on the door now. We've got a handle on this door. Now, this has got the plastic surround on it still on this block here. But I'm hoping with the insulation on the inside and the metal panel on the inside of the door as well, that I'm going to be able to retain that. If not, I'll have to put some other sort of locking mechanism on there. But that's something I'm going to have to come up against. I've put this thermostat gauge in the door now. And if I actually open the door, you can probably see, just sticking through there, is the temperature probe there. I don't know whether that's going to be okay there. It's just above the middle of the halfway of the oven. So I'm hoping for an even temperature, sort of at the higher end of the oven, from the middle upwards. I suppose that's where most of the stuff's going to be done. Opening the other door now, as you can probably see, all I've actually done there, I took a bit of angle iron and just sort of compressed the ends like that, and that holds the glass in perfectly. So there's a double layer of glass there. Looking directly into the oven, you can probably see top two corners there, I've put the oven lights and the grill lights, so that's in situ. So coming up to the top here, this is all fixed in place now, as you can see. Coming around to the back here, I'm just going to enclose all this along there. All I've done there, as you can see, is just two L brackets to hold these controller in place. The back of the oven, it's the elements are wired down. I'm going to enclose all this, also that'll be a whole enclosed panel. You won't see none of this at all. All elements, as you can probably see, are stone cold. No, nothing's been on at all. I've literally just finished it, just finished wiring it in. So I'm going to turn it on now. Controls are all set to off. So let's just turn it on. Right, I heard a click. We've got power to our controller up there. So if I turn on the main oven, how about it? Right, had a little bit of a hassle with trying to get all the elements to come on. And I couldn't get one of the elements to light up at all, even when you turn both dials. Lucky enough, I had the controller manual, because you had to start the timer working. It meant pressing one of the buttons, so that brought the other one on. It's coming up to temperature now. One thing I have noticed, though, this little temperature gauge here isn't really doing much. As you can see there, it's just not even coming on the scale yet. So I've just gone out now and bought an internal one. I'll show you that in a second. We've only just turned it on. It's actually hanging inside the oven. It's on its way up now. It's up to...
It's over 50.
50,
now
60.
It's on 70.
It's on 70 now, so it's climbing now rapidly. Right, there we go. I don't know whether you can see that or not. We're just over 190 degrees centigrade at the moment, and that's where we need to be. Thank you.